Gotta get a security detail on Mori while he's in the hospital. Agent Avesta will fill you in on what we know so far. As a token of interdepartmental cooperation.
Oh, thank you.
The nerve on her.
Like I said, they're alive.
Don't tell these people a thing, especially about that puzzle. This is our town. We're the ones that'll catch Riddler.
We didn't lose a single hostage. Whew.
I thought she was gonna bite your head off for a second.
That's awesome.
I'd like
bites
to see
the head
her
off
try.
Special Agent Enigma Vesta, Field Intelligence Specialist on the Riddler case. And my partner, Agent Blake.
How do you do?
I put together this psychological profile of Riddler.
Blake.
You'll see when you read it. He's changed. For your eyes only. If you catch my drift.
He has a mask on.
The target of the casino attack, Rumi Mori. Any idea what Riddler wanted with him?
He'll chop his finger
off. We figure it has something to do with why he's back in Gotham.
You want a solution
to
a riddle?
He was asking about a riddle.
What kind of riddle?
Something about a mind-bender that drove men to madness.
Interesting. I've heard that before. Thanks. That's a help. I'm Gotham born and raised, you know. My dad ran a store in the shadow of City Stadium. Yeah. I just wanted to say it's a real honor to meet you.
Oh, thank you.
I do have something I want to ask, though.
Uh-oh.
The criminally insane. You're drawn to them, aren't you?
Like moss to
There's
a flame.
There's something in you that pulls you towards the danger. The chaos. The energy. You can't keep away, can you?
It's unavoidable.
You can't go two city blocks in Gotham without tripping over criminal scum.
Most people just get up and run away.
Not me,
I'm
baby.
Not most people.
I think I know you a little better now.
Okay. Make your note in your little file there. Run along now.
I'll be in touch. Agent.
Batman, before you go. Gotham's your city. I respect that. But you should know I don't have to play nice.
Oh yeah, well neither
do I. I'm letting you hunt the Riddler for now.
Letting me?
You better share everything you find. Or... this courtesy call is gonna become something you really won't like. You get me? There's a lot of ways this could go.
I don't like threats.
I don't take kindly to threats, Waller.
Remember that too. Now I'll grapple away. Sashay away. Episode 1. The Enigma. Oh yeah, Edward Enigma. Right? Wasn't that his name? At least in the movies. But Jim Carrey played the Riddler? Like, this is gonna be a little bit of darker Riddler. Wayne Manor, 4:39 a.m. Who gets up at this time of the day? Cool. Chirp, chirp.
What an eventful evening.
Yes, my good man.
I've taken the liberty of preparing some refreshments.
Excellent.
Thanks, Al.
I just got this lament configuration thing here. Gonna try
to
open it.
Focus.
Bring the Cenobites.
Maybe music will help.
Oh, wow. If it runs out, what happens? Ambient.
Something with a beat.
The computer is finished scanning the Riddler's puzzle box.
Oh, goody.
It's ready when you are.
Let's get to work.
Then it's ready. Now, this is just for me to look at. I can't click on that. What happened? Oh, I'm walking, right? I can move? Well, I guess... I don't see anything I can interact with. So I guess I'm just walking up there. Oh wait, here we go. Dent!
Harvey Dent.
Became Two-Face.
He was a friend. Once. In the end, Harvey couldn't make a single decision without consulting his lucky coin. He's in Arkham Asylum now, with the rest of the criminally insane.
actually call him Two-Face now. Harvey Dent, corrupt mayor of Gotham. Harvey Dent was once a promising mayoral candidate and one of my closest friends. I supported his campaign and his vision for Gotham. After he was attacked by the Children of Arkham, he became Two-Face, a violent and deeply paranoid criminal. During his brief stint as mayor, he used his authority to enforce martial law throughout the city. Catwoman. Selina Kyle, thief for hire. Selina Kyle came to Gotham to perform a number of robberies for the Children of Arkham, though she eventually helped me stop them. She left Gotham during Lady Arkham's final assault on the city, and I don't know whether she'll ever return. Despite our differences, I enjoyed sparring with her. So I have something to say about... Two-Face? No dialogue here? Lady Arkham, Vicki Vale, terrorist leader. Vicki Vale was a well-known and respected reporter at the Gotham Gazette, but she was born Vicki Arkham, a victim of my father's criminal activities. She created her alter ego, Lady Arkham, and her terrorist organization, the Children of Arkham, to destroy Gotham's elite. I defeated her, but I don't know if she's alive or dead. Her body was never found. Penguin. Oswald Cobblepot. Revolutionary. Oswald Cobblepot was a terrorist, anarchist, and my oldest friend. Born to one of Gotham's most prestigious families, for some reason I want to say prodigious, he lived abroad after his mother was committed to Arkham Asylum by my father. He returned to Gotham to join the Children of Arkham, seeking revenge on my family for destroying his. Alright, so that's that. We've got four. This is the Hall of Criminals.
Oswald Cobblepot.
Yeah, okay.
The Penguin. My oldest friend.
Okay, so I have to manually go into them to have him hear him say something about it.
Vicki Vale, a.k.a. Lady Arkham. Driven to madness. Leader of the Children of Arkham.
Go this way. Sweetie!
Selina. She'll turn up again. I'm looking forward to it.
I'm sure you are. Alright, so... nothing else to look at over here. Howdy?
No explosives detected, no radioactivity. Nothing dangerous at all, so...
no hooks, no pins.
Computer, run another scan. I want to be absolutely sure this thing is safe.
Also, I took the liberty of digging up everything I could find on the agency.
There's plenty here. Know your enemy and all that.
Arthritis?
It comes and goes. Ever since the kidnapping and...
oh.
And all the other business with Lady Arkham. Alfred.
Do you have nerve damage?
No, don't you worry about me. I should be fine. It was worse after my first tour of duty.
Always worry about my family.
Your family, Alfred. We worry about family.
Thank you, Bruce.
Aww. It'll pass.
Working always helps.
Got stuff. Alright, agency data.
The agency.
Might as well go there first.
The public face of a shadow committee of military leaders, intelligence experts, and government officials. Civil rights violations, domestic black sites, decentralized accountability.
This information, it's all before Waller took over the director position. Perhaps she's given them a new direction.
Maybe. But the agency's empowered to override local law enforcement with impunity.
Oh, Batman's got some competition in town. I wonder if we need be worried about losing our unpaid and thoroughly exhausting job.
They're gonna make things harder.
Well, things won't be easy with a bunch of spies nearby. They're well-equipped spies, too.
Maybe it wouldn't hurt to talk to Lucius about upgrades. Try and level the playing field.
Yeah. I like Lucius. He was pretty cool. Gotham Feed. Gotham Media Feed. Gotham Citizens Support GCPD. Gotham City Police Department Batman Partnership by Julia Martins. Despite some heavy criticism from elected officials, the Gotham City Police Department's public partnership with the masked vigilante known as Batman has been a rousing success with the city's population. Across the board, crime in the Gotham City limits has been down from the previous year, with violent crimes hitting a record low. I'm just trying to look at it. Read the... Yeah, it's cut off, though. Alright. There is not enough money in the world. The Gotham Times has reported that many people are living beyond their means. There are many things that come into play when considering the importance of the health and well-being of its citizens. There are very few... something... Though some on the city council have raised concerns about Batman's hidden identity and his operation outside the restrictions of the law, it doesn't appear to be hurting public opinion. I don't care who he is. I care that he makes things safer, said grocery store owner Wayne Barton, whose business has seen a 50% spike in sales after dark in recent months. Councilmember Gail Rich is sympathetic to business owners like Barton, but she maintains, until we know who this Batman is, I don't think we could ever be truly safe. Wayne Enterprises stock hits record high by Mark Phillips. Wayne Enterprises stock hit a record high of $120 per share today during afternoon trading, surpassing its previous high of $115 per share over a year ago. The record high is the latest event in the company's recent hot streak since Bruce Wayne returned to the company as CEO last year following his brief ouster. Wayne was removed from the CEO position last year and replaced with Oswald Cobblepot in a move that resulted in Wayne publicly assaulting Cobblepot and being briefly admitted to Arkham Asylum. Wayne has since claimed the assault was a side effect of a drug injection at the hands of former Gazette reporter Vicki Vale, who conducted criminal business under the name Lady Arkham. Dent trial date pushed back again by Kate Clark. A federal judge has delayed the start of former Gotham Mayor Harvey Dent's criminal trial by several more months, following the departure of the defendant's entire legal team. The team, led by attorney Brandon Hoffman, announced that they were recusing themselves in a pre-trial hearing on Monday morning. Instead, Dent, who previously served as Gotham's district attorney, has insisted on representing himself in the trial. Oh yeah, more of a meeting beyond their means. There are many things that come into play when considering the importance of the health and well-being of its citizens. There are very few things that are worth mentioning in articles like this, as nobody seems to care. If it were up to me, I would write about cats and dogs. From the time the news was leaked, it has been established that there is something... I like that. That's funny. They're checking to make sure people read that stuff, which I did. In a statement in court, Hoffman said, I no longer feel I can defend Mr. Dent to the best of my ability. Judge Harriet Stokes then moved to delay the trial for two more months while Dent prepared his case. This is the fourth delay due to the trial and the third set... This is the fourth delay to the trial and the third set of attorneys to part ways with Dent, who is facing multiple charges of murder, criminal negligence, and fraud. Gazette Investigation. What is the Agency? By Julia Martins. It seems Batman is no longer the most mysterious crime fighter on the streets of Gotham City these days. Multiple sources from law enforcement have confirmed that the Gazette that a mysterious governmental entity known only as the Agency has been conducting operations in the city recently. On the record, there is no evidence of any federal crime-fighting organization by this name, but many sources who have requested anonymity have confirmed that the agency has been present at several recent crime scenes and exerted considerable authority. I have no idea who these people are, but when they show up, they're in charge, one officer said. They act like they know what they're doing, but with no way to check their track record, I guess we have to take them at their word. Officials say Cobblepot model prisoner. by Julia Martins. Good to hear it. In stark contrast with the ongoing saga of Harvey Dent's legal battle, former Wayne Enterprises CEO and convicted domestic terrorist Oswald Cobblepot is a model prisoner at Blackgate Prison. Yeah, CEO for like a day, huh? The man who briefly aligned himself with the terrorist organization Children of Arkham pleaded guilty to all charges against him earlier this year. He was sentenced to 40 years to be served in Blackgate. Observers and legal experts were surprised at Cobblepot's decision to forego a hearing in court, but from all accounts, he appears to be enjoying his new life in jail. "We don't have a bad thing to say about him," said one Blackgate guard, who wished to remain anonymous. "You get to talking to him, and he's actually pretty charming. He's super smart." He's super serial. Okay, I can't... Alright, that's it then. Alright. Before I go to the Riddler files, let's check out the Codex. James Gordon. "Over the past year, my partnership with Jim has flourished. I've finally won his trust, and Gotham City is a better place for it. Batman used to be hidden in the shadows, but Jim has helped me step into the light and find legitimacy. For that, I'm grateful. I think Jim is finally settling into his new role as police commissioner. It's been a difficult transition, and I don't think he'll ever be comfortable with the tragic way he received his promotion. But I trust he'll use his newfound authority to make the city a better place. Gotham is lucky to have him, and so am I. I couldn't ask for a better partner." Oh yeah? What about Robin? We saw a hint of a Robin near the end of the first game. Rene Montoya. "Things are looking up for Jim Gordon's favorite True Blue cop. Rene Montoya was recently promoted to detective after she was exonerated of the murder of Carmine Falcone. It was evidence I provided that proved she was under the influence of Lady Arkham's drug when she committed the crime. I admire Renee's dedication to law enforcement and fierce loyalty to Jim. It's evident that she lives for her work, often at the cost of her personal life. Sounds like a problem we both share." Lucius Fox, who I just mentioned. "There would be no Batman without Lucius Fox. In a sense, he's built me from Batsuit to Batmobile. Everything I am, everything I've become, I owe to him. A brilliant engineer and trusted confidant, Lucius is one of the few people I can depend on in this world. In addition to being Wayne Enterprises' technological leader, I've entrusted him to run a secret R&D wing where he designs and develops new bat tech." Alfred Pennyworth. "I am not my father's son. I am Alfred's. After my mother and father were murdered, he was the one who did the hard work of raising me. It couldn't have been easy for him, making sure he instilled the right values and steered me away from the vices of my father. Steadfast, true, and compassionate, Alfred knows me better than anybody, certainly better than I know myself. He's my moral compass and my best friend. Last year, he was kidnapped by Lady Arkham. During the ordeal, she maimed him. Alfred lost his eye. I still feel terrible at what happened. I hope he can recover from the physical and emotional trauma. Then again, he's tougher than he looks." Did he lose his eye? I'm hoping these choices imported right. I don't remember that. Iman Avesta. "It was Special Agent Iman Avesta who handed me the psychological profile on Riddler. I don't know much about her, other than she's a Gotham native and seems to have the confidence of Amanda Waller. She's also a huge fan of Batman, which is somewhat relieving. Maybe I can use that to my advantage in further dealings with the agency." Amanda Waller. "I got my first glimpse at Amanda Waller outside the casino after Riddler's grisly attack on Rumi Mori. A former congressional aide and political science PhD, Waller's irrepressible ambition has shot her straight to the top of the government's top covert law enforcement organization, the agency. She's recently been promoted to regional director with a jurisdiction that spans the entire northwestern United States, including Gotham City. Gordon doesn't like her, that much is clear. Understandable. She's a force of nature who's threatening his turf. I just wish I knew more about her intentions towards Gotham. She seems like she could be a powerful friend, but an even more powerful enemy." Oh, that's actually it. Vernon Blake. "Special Agent Blake. Avesta's terse partner. I met him as Batman after Riddler's attack on the casino. Not much to say about him at the moment." Well, just the fact that he's in here means he's gonna play some kind of role in this. The Riddler. The Riddler is an old name in Gotham, one we thought was gone for good. He was dangerous enough that even Carmine Falcone, Mayor Hill, and my father left him alone. An international terrorist wanted by Interpol and hunted by the agency, the Riddler's modus operandi is to torture and kill his marks by forcing them to solve his macabre riddles. According to the agency's profile on him, Riddler's got a genius-level IQ and exhibits signs of narcissistic and obsessive-compulsive personality disorders. He is cruel, calculating, and merciless, and I will bring him down. Rumi Mori. There are two sides to Rumi Mori, the face he shows to the public and the person he really is. The person he keeps in the shadows, hidden from the prying eyes of public society. Mori wants everyone to believe he's a model citizen. He paints his public persona with philanthropy and a seemingly legitimate business empire. But take a closer look behind the mask, and you'll catch a glimpse of the real Rumi Mori, war profiteer and murderer. He made his fortune running guns during the Arab Spring, and soon after diversified into high-tech weaponry. Of course, Mori's illicit activities have never been proven in the court of law. Riddler had some bone to pick with Mori. Perhaps that's why he taunted him at the Virago. It's not surprising a man like that would have enemies. I wonder how he made one of the Riddler. Yeah, so I actually. The Agency. One of the nation's most clandestine national security organizations. The agency operates in the darkest shadows of the criminal justice system. Not much is known about their day-to-day operations, but with little information I can dig up about them is that the agency's influence is awe-inspiring, stretching across international borders and reaching the highest echelons of political power. Thomas Wayne. My father, and possibly the worst criminal this city has ever known. Thomas Wayne. I once thought he was a hero, a man who died trying to protect my mother and I from a bullet of a common crook. I was wrong. Dead wrong, Buster. I found the truth about my father not long ago. He wasn't the philanthropic doctor he pretended to be. He was a monster who amassed our family's wealth by drugging and gaslighting Gotham's wealthiest families and robbing them of their fortunes. He devastated lives and destroyed minds. To rob someone of their sanity is one of the worst things you... I was reading that. To rob someone of their sanity is one of the worst things you can do to a person. I would know. Lady Arkham robbed me of mine as recompense for my father's sins. I hope that debt is paid. I want nothing more than to leave his dark legacy in the past. Martha Wayne. My mother, the mystery. I witnessed her and my father's assassination when I was just a child, so my memories of her are far and few between, but I cherish each one. Okay, we need some proofreading in here, guys. Stat. It's unclear what she knew or how involved she was with my father's crimes, but there's a part of me who wants to believe the best about her. Maybe she was left in the dark. Maybe she tried to stop him. I just don't know. I need to believe that there is a part of me that is good, and that part is my mother. Yeah, who knows, really? Gotham City, population 10.5 million. Gotham City is more than my hometown. It's my passion project. When I look out onto that skyline, I don't see a city. I see a living, breathing organism that keeps evolving, adapting to new threats. I must adapt with it. The criminals this place attracts are no different. There was a time when all you had to worry about was wise guys and street thugs, but crime, too, has evolved. The crime rate might be down, but the villains are becoming more and more bizarre, more terrifying. Sometimes I think crime is a virus that keeps mutating into more virulent strains, and the city is sick with it. I'll let Batman be the cure. Arkham Asylum, established November 1921, Gotham City's only maximum security psychiatric hospital. I was committed here for a couple days after I was drugged by Lady Arkham and was incited to attack Oswald Cobblepot. So this place doesn't exactly hold the best memories for me. That's one of the reasons I'm renovating it. Once outdated and dilapidated, Wayne Enterprises has promised to bring this antiquated asylum into the 21st century by turning it into a state-of-the-art mental health facility. Wayne Enterprises, established 1870. Multinational corporation founded by my ancestors, covering all manner of technology, manufacturing, and finance. I inherited a majority stake from my parents and have recently become more involved in its day-to-day operations. So far, so good. Stocks are up, and Wayne Enterprises' R&D department is developing some pretty exciting new technologies.
Multinational corporations, genocide of the starving nation.
Park Row, Gotham City, Crime Alley. The squalid downtown alley where my parents were assassinated. The street across from the Monarch Theater is the place where my childhood ended and the rest of my life began, violently. I installed a plaque there to honor my parents before they knew the truth of my father's criminality. Oh, we're in depth here. Looks like the last one, though. Gotham City Police Department HQ. The GCPD is Gotham's first line of defense against criminals both mundane and bizarre. When mobster Carmine Falcone was in power, he kept at least half the force in his pocket, but not all of them. James Gordon was one of the few he could not corrupt. Yeah, proofread. Since Falcone and Mayor Hill were taken down, Gordon has worked to clean up the corruption in the department. Crime rates have fallen dramatically since Gordon took over as police commissioner. Since Wayne Enterprises pledged to rebuild Arkham Asylum, the GCPD has worked closely with the facility to determine which criminals should go to Arkham for rehabilitation and which belong in Blackgate Prison. Okay. And finally, Riddler Files.
Yes, Riddler terrorized this city long before you were Batman. Mm.
Gotham's original costumed criminal.
Really, the first?
Yes, to have him returned, it's unsettling. I remember when he was the scourge of the underworld. Even Carmine Falcone gave him a wide berth.
Yep.
He was presumed dead for so long. Why come back to Gotham?
And Thomas Wayne.
Well, he seemed to have a prior relationship with Mori. Some kind of axe to grind. Let me upload the rest of this to the Codex.
Some kind of deal gone bad?
The agency realized Riddler was still alive when he orchestrated a prison break at Peñaduro.
Peñaduro?
My men here say you let yourself get caught, Mr. Riddler.
Just Riddler.
Why willingly turn yourself in?
Oh, Mr. Warden, to get everyone else out, of course.
Just Warden.
That wasn't obvious.
The man's deranged.
Hmm.
If you ask me, he needs help. He's clearly sick. The man is in urgent need of a doctor.
His victims need
his
help.
His victims are the ones who need help.
I'll concede you have a point.
Oh, thank you, my good man.
What was that?
You should see your face. Its confusion is delightful. I think I'll take it with me.
His face? He took his face off?
I take everything back.
Uh-huh. Okay, do we add the codex? I don't think we added anything. He said he was adding the codex. Anything new here? So I can't scroll. It's not, it should be the same. Like I can't scroll in the other, in the codex. And those, you pull the thing down, which you can't do here. I guess we're done. Let's open the lament configuration.
See what Riddler's little gift is all about.
Solve my puzzle soon, or people will get hurt. Mm. Riddler's MO hasn't changed in all these years.
He was just playing a cute little tune. Duck from the hooks. What am I supposed to do? Shake it around? What? shake it? I shake it? I shake it, shake it? Is that what I do? Nothing's happening. I'm shaking it really quick. Am I supposed to press arrows? Literally nothing's happening here. Wider circles. Okay. This is getting really
There's
particular.
There's writing engraved along the rim. I have an eye, yet cannot see. Who am I?
A needle.
That sounds familiar. I've heard it before.
Don't happen to remember the answer, do you?
A sewing needle?
Sadly, no.
I have a needle. Could be that too. Blind justice. Kind of a stretch, right? Eye of a needle?
The eye of a needle.
But how does that relate to the object in question?
No idea.
Maybe it's telling us how to use it.
Sounds very plausible.
Look at these strange grooves.
It's getting the groove. We'll be able to flatten it down. Maybe we can stretch it back out into a, what do you call it? Like a needle shape. I got movie tickets? Alright.
Never forget.
His parents. I don't suppose anything new here. I'll just check. No. Yeah, I don't need to be down here. Let me just see if this play desk.
Needle. A record needle.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's a record.
A chance of stopping a whole lot of pain. Okay. To be honest, you're already doing better than I thought.
Okay.
But don't sit around feeling pleased with yourself. Unless you want to see me tear this city apart.
I suppose you're going to look in there.
So,
an open invitation from the Riddler? Of course.
This is pre-recorded.
Looks like I'm manipulating radio bands or waveforms. Something. I'm not sure what I'm looking at or how any of it is actually displaying.
Huh.
And that sound.
I guess he was talking live to me.
What? Oh, I'm not really sure about any of it. Get Lucius on the line, will you?
It's taking control of his mind.
Hey, Alfred.
Good morning, Lucius. I hope we're not interrupting your breakfast.
Too late.
My youngest is probably stealing all the bacon, but duty calls.
Bruce is going to attack Alfred.
This is a puzzle from
Riddler. Alright, maybe not.
There's a strange waveform pattern I can manipulate inside that needs your expertise.
Okay. I can meet you at Wayne Tower in a little bit. We'll fire up the R&D lab.
I wouldn't ask if it wasn't important, Lucius.
No, don't worry about it. It's actually going to be a big day for me. Tiffany starts at Wayne Enterprises.
Tiffany? Really?
Who's your that? Daughter, working alongside you.
Oh.
How wonderful.
Certainly is. Bruce, I'll see you soon.
Bye, Lucius. Can't wait to see Tiffany.
It's one of my favorite names. Access the back computer anytime by ending the back cave from the main menu. Right, we saw that. Under extras or something?
Good hunting, Bruce.
Thank you. We can't do that. Alright, never mind. It quits out of the game if we do that, so. Dun, 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 dun. Wayne Tower, 8:37 a.m. Still freaking early as hell. He just got his bat attaché case. That's the Bruce.
Excellent. Glad I caught you. I have some good news to share.
Good to hear it, Regina.
Oh yeah.
It's what I've come to expect, with you as Wayne Enterprises chairperson.
I just talked to the board, and our stock price has doubled since you took the company back from Oswald Cobblepot.
That's good.
The Gazette's running a piece about it.
Look, I would love to hear all the details, but I've got a meeting with Lucius I've got to run to.
Well, I don't mean to pry, but what's in that case?
If I told you,
it seems like an odd thing.
I'd have to kill you.
Around the office.
Something for Lucius.
Oh, this? No. This is just something for Lucius.
I see. Well, I've got a meeting I've got to run to. We'll pick up this conversation this afternoon.
Sounds great.
And when we talk then, I'm not telling you what's in the case. Biatch.